plan on what we're gonna do about all these deserters?
We're not doing anything with them, Bailey.
Are you kidding me? These people abandoned the ETA. They're traitors.
We're sticking with the mission. You can go back to Corrigan empty-handed, or you can fall in line.
Ryder, this is Dr. Skurlock. I must profess it has been a delight to have met yourself and your companion.
We're grateful for the help, Doctor. But I have to ask, your antidote to the fungus, why do you keep it to yourselves out here? Our people are trapped in the valley. If they knew that...
Yes, if they knew, think about it. What's the first thing they would do? They would be so afraid of the other side getting it, they'd have me locked up. War is all they know how to think about. Those narrow-minded, tribal idiots... Here, it's different. We are all free. We don't live in fear of our neighbors slitting our throats. Men and women, allies and enemies. Here, nature, the elements, are our only enemy.
Sounds too good to be true.
Well, it's... we do what we can do. Resources are scarce. But you and your companions may stay as long as you need.
Thank you.
I will be handling your induction.
Induction? As I told Skurlock, we're just passing through.
Skurlock has no say in who stays or leaves. I'm in command of the camp security.
Sure, but this camp wouldn't exist without Skurlock and his vaccine.
And Skurlock wouldn't exist without my soldiers.
Can I do anything for you?
It pleases me that you won't be here long.
Should be interesting. Count me in.
Thank you.
Jakob, I've found the truck.
What's it look like?
Exactly as we left it.
You have something in common, then. Get that oil pump, will you?
Okay, I've got the pump from the truck.
Good. Now hurry back. This meathead Kang hasn't stopped giving me the side eye.
Screw till they push back, then loosen a little. You forget everything I taught you.
Taught me? You think you taught me anything, old man? Unbelievable.
Feisty. She definitely got her temper from you.
Looks like we're taking a break. I guess you've earned the right to hear the full story. So, a long time ago, before this shitty planet, before we even left Earth, I was flying workers to the Caravelle Orbit Station. The flames started to surround me, and I tried to find an exit. And that's when I tripped, and I saw this damn pregnant woman lying under the rubble. I was able to save both of us. Well, Sri.
Hold on. You were there during the Caravelle disaster?
All the survivors of the Caravelle were given a free ticket aboard the brand new Floris, and I met her again. Right here, in Trenchtown. Her child was born. It was a girl, and she named her Chana. Then that little brat was only 6 when she saw her mother killed right in front of her.
So you raised her.
Go on. The truck isn't going to fix itself.
Thank you.
Hey, Jakob. That was a sweet story back there, but it still doesn't explain why Channa hates your guts.
Why do you think? I didn't ask to be a father in a shithole like this. You know what the survival rate is for kids? But turns out I was wrong. Little girl managed to grow up after all.
Who knows? Maybe you did her a favor. If you hadn't been such a bad...